Friends, today's NRI Samay program from Los Angeles brought to you commercial free by listeners like you. Your generous donations make possible for us to stay commercial free, and today's show is pre-recorded. If you have a question for the guest, please send an email to nrisamay@gmail.com. We will follow up with the guest and find the answer for you. Thank you for your support.
So friends, welcome back to NRI Samay Social Radio. On this Saturday, we'll be talking to a man with a mission, famously or fondly called the Bridgeman. He is building bridges that link places, people and hearts. So he defines his wealth as abundant joy and gratitude in the face of villagers to whom he would help construct bridges. This is Girish Bharadwaj and his organization, Grama Bharata Setu Nirman Pratisthana. Construct suspension footbridges over rivers and streams, enabling thousands in remote villages in India to experience a new way of life. So, Girishji built his first bridge only because of the faith of the villagers had in him, and was successful even with a small budget and no prior experience. At least this is what I've read when I was first reading about Girish Bharadwajji. So we'll talk to him and find out what kept him going, the motivations, and how did his vision end up constructing almost close to 120 bridges. Girish ji, namaste, and welcome to the program, namaste. Sir.
Welcome. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. So first of all, I wanted to start you by asking, tell us, how did this idea of building bridges first start up, sir, in your mind?
People came with a photograph of Lakshman Jula and requested me to build a bridge. Actually, I'm running a workshop, general fabrication and repairs of farm machinery, since 1975. It is in 89 people came to me requesting for a hanging bridge. So I said, I'm a mechanical engineer, I don't know anything about it. But they had a lot of confidence. They said, if you mind, you can do it. We have to do it, they are in trouble. So I referred some books and consulted my friend on Mr. Sumitra, civil engineer, and we designed the bridge. Mm-hmm. Then it was according to IRC specification. They took it to the government officials and MLA. They said for hanging bridge we don't have funds. There is no grant for that. So they came back. They said design an economical bridge which we can afford. We will contribute for that. And I said, you don't pay anything to me. I'll guide you. I'll get the work done through you only. You just spend for material. We will build it, I said. So together we built a simple need-based design bridge. They provided all the material and the volunteers came. I guided them and it was built.
Which place is this, sir? What is your first bridge and what was your experience at that time?
It is fantastic. All people participation, you know, preparing tea and everything on the riverside. The people used to participate happily. Because it was very much essential for them. So there was a boat where it was broken actually. So that time, inevitably they wanted to have the bridge. It was in the month of July, August. Floods were there, then we built it. So that experience motivated me. People started expressing their gratitude. And for 2-3 years, there was no response. Then some government officials came and saw the bridge. When this news came in the media, newspaper and all, they came and saw. They found out this is the most economical and safe means of making people crossing the river. So then after 1993 onwards, some government funding started. Then we continued. Their gratitude motivated me. Then we started designing simple bridges. Then later, according to IRC, it has been heavy bridges. Heavy means not vehicular, for pedestrians only. Like that, it continued. Karnataka, Kerala is the neighboring Kasaragod district, is there also. Started calling. Then we kept on improving the quality and making it a long lasting. And now, more stable bridges with different designs, right? So, afterwards, the columns and other things, all RCC, according to IRC, we started building. But these stiffeners, the hanging bridges are safe even without stiffeners. Stiffeners means when a crowd go there over the bridge, and the bridge gets lowered. So we provide stiffeners. The theory part of it, I referred books and the bridge of this is the Golden Gate Bridge of San Francisco and this Brooklyn approach between New York and Long Island. I referred books and I studied about it. Same design, simplified with the indigenous material we built it here.
Wow.
We built here.
Excellent. So I was seeing those pictures on your website, which is the Grama Bharata Setu Nirman Pratisthana. So it's like the gbsn.org. Incredible pictures, sir. Amazing feel, you know. I really get motivated to see if there is any place where there are no bridges and then quickly jump in, you know. It's such an incredible, you know.
Thank you.
Amazing. So, sir, where is this first bridge actually? It's in which place in Karnataka?
It is Sullia Taluka, the South Kanada district, Dakshina Kannada district. Sullia, it is a taluk headquarters, very near to that, 3 kilometers, Payasuni River.
Ah, okay. So you mentioned that you've been building bridges in Karnataka, Kerala. You also, I think recently you're looking out for Orissa as well. So when you worked in multiple states, multiple cultures, so what was your experience working for multiple states, sir? Your language is different, culture is different, people are different, their expectations are different. Well, what makes you comfortable?
Yeah, Kerala, Malayalam I knew, it is a neighboring district, no?
Mm-hmm.
So people speak here Malayalam also. And I learned more Malayalam when I went far from our place. No? So no other language. So I could, about 32 bridges we have built in Kerala. And 3 bridges in Andhra Pradesh. There also we had one translator, Hindi. It was a wonderful experience. Huh? Then Orissa, we did not have any problem. People speak Hindi. I can speak Hindi.
So I'm from.
Not a problem.
Yeah, I'm from Andhra Pradesh. I was wondering where in Andhra Pradesh did you construct these bridges, sir? Next time
Andhra
I go, I'll visit.
One bridge between Raghavaya Park and Ambedkar Park in Vijayawada, and 2 bridges at Lakhnavaram. Lakhnavaram, it is not for creating connectivity to the village. It is a place where there is a Lakhnavaram reservoir is there, a very big lake. The Kammam River was constructed as a dam, and there are villages surrounding that lake, about 4 or 5 villages. Those people are indulged in Naxal activities, and government of Andhra Pradesh wanted to create some employment to them. The tourist people used to come there, cook on the side of the lake, and eat, drink, break bottles and go. So systematically they wanted to create this employment as well as create some tourism. So tribal tourism, they had a plan. And there is a nearby village, Busapur. The people of Busapur village, you know, they are provided employment. So the hillocks have become islands. From this lake Bantu, first island, first island, the second island. In the second island is a big island where they are constructing resorts, swimming pool is there, and the motorboat is there. So these people are trained in the motorboat operation, preparing fast food, this, that, and all. So it was a wonderful experience. Those people, they were looking at us with suspicious eyes. And when the work was completed, they became so nice. And when I left the place, they wept, and whole village.
They touched my feet.
It is something fascinating for them. It is something new. Yeah. And moreover, I used to talk to them very nicely. They were asking so many innocent questions. For example, one thing: here the people, the land, the Maliks, they don't even allow us to see what when they eat. But you are eating with the workmen together. How we are doing it? I said, "Kaun Malik hai? Sab ka Malik hai kya? Ye log mere bachche jaise hai." Then he felt so happy. His eyes were. He asked me, the sarpanch of the panchayat. He told me, "Can you consider me one among them?" Then I couldn't. I just touched his shoulder and told him, "Tammudu, here my brother is." His eyes were wet. Did not drop down, but only wet eyes. So nice it was. Afterwards, he is calling. Even now, sometimes he calls me. Bagunara, he calls me. Sir, Bagunara. Further, I cannot speak.
Yeah.
And another man, Samay was there. He is no more. He had tuberculosis. He was also like that. It was a fantastic experience. So that is why I have included. We build bridges between places, people, and hearts. Really.
Absolutely true, sir. Yeah. Absolutely. And not they touching your feet. And if I visit your place, I would definitely touch your feet. You know, it's so incredible to connect these people and these lives. And unbelievable. And also, sir, I was just wondering, how do you decide where to build the bridge? You mentioned that you've built bridge in the place I hail from. I hail from Vijayawada. And the place that you mentioned, Prakasam Barrage and all, whatever you're mentioning, I've seen that, you know, I can't believe that it's Girish Bharadwaj, whom I'm talking to, has been instrumental in constructing that bridge. So how do you decide these places, sir? Do you take requests from rural people who are suffering, or what's your criteria?
Delegates come from village, sir, we want a bridge. Then I visit the site, prepare designs and drawings. They take it to the government officials and local elected leaders. After some time, the amount is granted. This Vijayawada bridge, actually, an engineer contractor, he came to me. That time, I was in the hospital, I had some cardiac problem in lung vega. Then he came to me. There, no, between Raghavaya Park and Ambedkar Park, one bridge was built, steel bridge. It was designed by Vijayawada Nyukale. That collapsed. Then they wanted to construct with the ring foundation. This is a Krishna canal of Krishna River.
Right.
Something happened. There's something wrong with it. He came with that. Came to me with the request that whether on the same abutments we can build a suspension bridge. I said, well, we can do it. The abutments are strong. Drill and put double bars and erect the columns. Then anchor the blocks. So then I gave all the designs and drawings. He constructed the columns. And did all the fabrication work according to my drawings. Then he could not do the erection work. That time it was almost 6 months. I was almost all right. So I went there with my five people and we erected the bridge. Full erection, assembly was there.
So, tell us a little bit. You mentioned you're going with five people from your team and also. These people who wanted to have that bridge will collaborate with the government agencies, and they also go to their MLA. You know, very long drawn process. Nothing would move forward. You know, going to these government officials is like going towards hitting a dead end in many places, right? So yes, how do you take your team? How does these people go to their MLAs? How is this whole spectrum of things working, sir?
All the proposals are not accepted. In some places, what happens? They want to have a pakka bridge. So in the villages, they have different opinions. Sometimes there is no other way. Small villages, no. Government will not spend a lot of money. They look at the population versus investment ratio. So small amount they grant. Then this is the only means with the economic bridges. No? Then they come back to me. In some places, the proposals are dropped. If I do a survey this year, no? Somewhere next year, the project will come. For the past 2-3 years, I had continuous bridges. Now the government has changed. In Karnataka, for the time being, there are no more works here. No? Only one is left now. Orissa, 2 bridges are there. We had given proposal for 3 bridges. They called me, the superintendent of police and district collector. They called me. I went there and surveyed about 40 bridges. Out of that, one bridge was built last year against over Nagavali River. It is very close to the Rayagada district headquarters. From Vishakhapatnam, it is 200 kilometers. Oh. Then there we don't take. I told them in Karnataka, Nirmiti Kendra, they do. I don't invest for the bridge. I cannot run after you for that and proceed with this and all. Then they gave it to the police housing corporation. Then they called for tenders. One workshop owner, Mr. Naren, he took the contract and he supplied all the material. I took about 12 people from here. And others, he provided people, we built it in 3 months. Now, this year, 2 more bridges. One is across Nagavali River only, another is in Gudari. One is 100 meters, another is 250 meters we have to build. It is a tender process over, and I think he is likely to get a work order. 20th, I am going there for marking.
Okay. So, when you're going like this, the most important thing is a lot of these engineering graduates, these kids, don't even know that Girish Bharadwaj is one man who's building bridges, who's going around places, right? And of course, media has got their own priorities. I am also ignorant that Girish Bharadwaj, there's a person called Girish Bharadwaj who's doing so much of incredible work.
No, there are people. People are coming for internship and training when they... From Roorkee Engineering College, before last year, two boys had come. Last year, from NITK, one boy had come. And this year also, one boy had come here. He just completed 1 month, he had a vacation. He got training about design and construction. He was observing. I motivate people in our country, there are many villages which are not reached. There are many villages. In Rayagada district itself, about 100 villages are required in Orissa, one district itself.
Wow.
I'm getting aged. I'm 53 now. And moreover, we cannot go all over India.
Right.
So I said, you can make your living as well as you can make others live better.
So
people are coming, taking training. I don't know, they are not coming forward afterwards. A lot of infrastructure. I have a workshop, my general fabrication also. So I could develop our own infrastructure, the molds, this, that, and all. From bridge to bridge, we know how to solve the problem and all. And every bridge, every place focuses on new challenges.
I know.
That also we have to see. So these people, I don't know why. And moreover, nowadays, manpower is a problem. I have got a very good team. I have motivated. I told you, you read about me, you know, the feeling of what we have. This is God's work.
Right.
No, something like that. You might have read in some paper, no? In Ramayana's sequence, in that Tulsidas, Prabhu aaye more ghat par maine utarvi. Jab aunga main tore ghat par mohi utariyo. So people, when we they only make arrangements for people to cross the river. I think then it will be helpful for us to cross the Bhavasagar.
Oh, very
that type of feeling.
Yes, absolutely, sir. And you definitely crossed it, you know, not one time, but numerous times.
Thank you.
And
with that holy feeling.
No, it's more than a holy feeling. You know, a few years back, I saw an image where I was seeing, I think this is in Orissa, if I'm true, but I'll have to really check back that picture and send it to you. I've seen few of these girls hanging around a rope and then crossing a bridge, you know. Or
MP, I've seen that.
You've seen that, right, sir? I was like surprised.
Yeah, yeah.
And that point in time, I was actually browsing. Unfortunately, I still on Google couldn't get Girish Bharadwaji. But then when I browsed it, I saw a guy from, if I remember properly, he's from Norway or someone. He's like building bridges, and then, you know, he goes to various different countries and then builds bridges.
Yeah. It is Mr. Tony Rutiman. Mr. Tony Rutiman from Switzerland, he came to me. He was here with me for 10 days.
Excellent.
He's totally, I'm actually very small in front of him. He's a, I think he's a, remember the word epsilon.
Epsilon
in mathematics it comes. However, small but not zero. But I'm just an epsilon.
My goodness.
Mr. Tony Rutiman, no, he's a wonderful man. No? He dedicated for rural connectivity. His story is a wonderful story. In Ecuador, there was an earthquake 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And he that time he was immatriculate.
Mm-hmm.
And he was... he could not go to the military. There, in Switzerland, military training is a compulsory training after matriculation. No?
Right.
So he was not selected. He had some problem, health problem.
Mm-hmm.
So 2 years he had to be at home before going to the professional course. Then he saw in television that earthquake, this one, losses in Ecuador.
Mm-hmm.
So he went there to help. Then there was a need for a bridge in a village. So he consulted some Dutch engineer from capital. And I got idea of a hanging bridge. He built a simple bridge by requesting the rig owners, oil rig owners, he got the pipes and ropes also. Through villagers, he got the first bridge built. That one had taken 6 months. He came back to his, he joined an engineering college. Then he left the course. So even after 5 years, after became an engineer, it'll be very late. I'll go not out right now. So he went, his parents objected. Then he said, you're going to spoil your life, he said. Here is his father told him. He said, I'm going to make others live better. No problem, no matter my life is lost. So he went there and he constructed about 200 and odd bridges in Ecuador, almost saturated. Then that time, this Laos, Vietnam, Myanmar. Now he was working in Myanmar last month.
Hmm.
He's a wonderful. He has built more than 500 bridges.
He's a wonderful.
He was here with me for about 10 days. He was looking at my bridges. He was telling,
mm-hmm.
His bridges are so simple, no stiffeners, but needs the purpose. Fulfilled the need.
Mm-hmm.
Then he told me, my bridges are, I'm following a principle, KISS, he said. What is that? KISS. Keep it simple and safe.
Mm-hmm.
He said, his bridges are simple but safe. And finally he told me, your business also, kiss only, keep it safe and strong, he said. So there's the difference. Wonderful man.
Yeah.
Often he sends me email.
Amazing.
So,
I think I'm
very small. I'm very small in front of you. I'm dedicated for that life. But I have got other workshop for my living. I have got a workshop.
Mm-hmm.
And now I don't do free service. I take all the salary and other things from there. Mine is the purpose is good, not the worker,
right?
Not the person.
Right. an incredible man, definitely. And it would be great if we can get him on NRI Samay as well. We'll be delighted, and really, it'll be an honor to talk to him. Of course, already talking to Girish Bharadwaj itself is an immense feeling for us, and thank you for making it again. And sir, I wanted to ask you this. How long does it typically take to construct a bridge, sir?
Depends on the span and the site conditions. A small 30-meter or 40-meter bridge can be built within a month. Last month, we have built a bridge in 27 days. It is a remote place in Karnataka, about 30 kilometers from the Talagad quarter. And last year, we have built one bridge, 165-meter long. Another part of the village, we had to build another bridge to the tributary. So this year we have built. It is the 327. Long span bridges, 100, 200 meters are about 3 to 4 months. 200 meters will take about 5 months.
200 meters will
the
take 5
height, height of the tower depends on the span. So tall towers will take a little more time. And sometimes accessibility, sometimes road approach, it is that. All the there are so many factors which influence the time limit.
right. And sir, in the entire span of your career, you know, it's like you've built close to 120 bridges now. So how many of them were non-government projects, and how many of them were wherein you had collaborated with the government?
About 6 bridges are non-governmental. And 12 bridges they are built without the columns, the living trees on the banks of rivers. But 40-60 up to 56 meters they have built bridges directly tying the rope to the trees, and the anchor is also the tree behind. Like that we have built all wooden planks deck flooring. About 6 bridges are like that. Not only that, even with the columns also, some six bridges local project, totally people's land. Our first bridge, our 50th bridge, and the recently built one, it is 120th bridge. It was all local participation only.
Local participation. Which place is this, sir?
Yeah.
Which place is this in Karnataka?
One is Alati, our own village, Alati village.
Okay.
Sullia Taluk. Second one is Shishila. It is in Beltangadi Taluk. Shishila. And the third one is now in Morse, M-O-R-S-E, Morse in Kumta Taluka.
Oh, this is all in Kerala or Karnataka?
No, Karnataka.
Karnataka.
Oh, okay. Kerala, there was a program, Janaki Asutrana Paddhati, means people campaign program. Mm-hmm. So they had to invest about 10 to 15%, they had local people had to invest. Rest the government used to give. In a village, here a village called Balwantraka in Rasu district, they did not have, they were all poor people. They said, sir, only 85% only granted, other what to do for that. I said, you people work with us. So I think I can say something and give it to you back. Because you collect the sand, they do the earthwork, help for concreting. You have your sweat equity.
Right.
So they participated like that, 2-3 villages are built with the local participation. Partly government, partly local.
Right. Sir, when you go a lot of places around the country, and then you see the need and necessity of the people around to figure out, did you ever feel that there is one place that you felt there is an absolute need for bridge, and then it's still not constructed, sir?
Yeah. There is a place called in Beltangadi, in Karnataka only, or South Karnataka street only.
Mm-hmm.
About 72 meters span. So many proposals are given. There, once two children died because they could not go for medical assistance. There are heavy floods there. And last year, one boat accident was there. One lady and one gentleman, they died. I'm thinking, still we'll try. Otherwise, I'm going to, before I stop constructing bridges, I want to build a bridge on my own cost. It is such a place. Even the local people know, there are so many accidents are happening there. Absolutely needed. And In Karnataka, different places, there are villages which are not reached. We see in newspaper, but I did not go there. This place I have gone. There are so many places. In North Kendra district, I mean, you know, the Karnataka is a coastal line, no? South Kendra and North Kendra, two districts are there, no?
Mm-hmm.
Then North Kendra, there are so many places. Always we see in newspapers, there is need for bridge.
Mm-hmm. So you mentioned about one bridge where kids are really losing lives. You already mentioned two of these kids have lost their lives. Which place is that, sir?
It is Narthikallu. Narthikallu in Beltanagar Taluk.
Narthikallu. Okay. Sir, if anybody, let's imagine a few of our NRIs are listening to the show and they'll show interest in donating or collaborating with you, or if they have their ideas of their place where people are suffering, how do they reach out to you, sir? What's the process that you follow generally?
NRIs, but some people they call me. In the process, I said that for that only I formed this. My workshop name is Ayasshilpa. It's a steel sculpture workshop, general fabrication workshop.
Uh-huh.
And this I formed this Gram Bharat Sitirman to take fund. If the people are there to contribute, to take it, take funds from them, and this do some bridges. Without government, where the government funding is not there, I wanted to construct. But our system, I could not get permission for it. And they said, ATG and all I wanted to, because our government people did not accept it. So it is a business, we cannot give you. How can I take a fund from outside? For that also, we'll have to pay a lot of tax. Huh? So I dropped it.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Our India, yeah, very sad thing is, it is not easy. This is Mr. Tony, no? Tony Bridgeman from Switzerland.
Right.
He came here, he's getting ropes free of cost. The cable car owners from in Switzerland.
Yes.
When the rope diameter reduces by 2 m, they get the rope and they put new rope. First ropes are kilometers together, ropes are there. Nowadays, they are donating them. Mr. Tony, come and take this many kilometers of rope. Mm. So he said he had access rope. He said he was thinking that India is a poor country. So there is a bridge man. So I can help him by giving all the ropes and all free of cost. He came to me to give rope. But ropes, he can give any amount of ropes, any different diameter. But here our system is very bad. If I want to bring that rope here, no, I'll have to spend more than the cost of the rope.
Hmm.
So I dropped it. So we cannot bring it. All customs, the duties, and this checkpoints, everything, all trouble only.
Wow.
So I said this is not possible. Our system is very bad. Yeah. I'm very sad to say that, but we cannot do like that.
Right.
Here. Nobody will believe that. See, when I go to the sites, site investigation, preparing design, drawing and all, I was doing free of cost. It is my own cost because it's a service. And for construction only, I take the charger. But people are not, nobody recognizes that here, government officials, they are in this world. Even when in the beginning, I was working because of their request, I said the procedures, no? I became a contractor. I used to pay for EMD, then take this one order, then construct. Then afterwards, to get my bills also, a lot of money is spent. So many times I have lost money because of the bridge. Once I wanted to give up.
Wow.
For my delay, I got my workshop.
Right.
So
right.
Why to go for the, we land into trouble, I thought. Then for the people just to come and request like anything. That time it happened. I heard that bhajan of Ramayana. No?
Right.
Again got interested. I thought better I'll not get trapped in the government system. Then when government official came to me, I said I don't invest. I will work for you. I don't want profit, but I don't want to lose my time and money.
Right.
Now. System is changed through Nirmiti Kendras, District Nirmiti Kendras.
Mm-hmm.
There is a Malnad Area Development Board in Karnataka. It is seven districts where heavy rain fed areas. No?
Mm-hmm.
So they took for the past 2-3 years they took projects, and 22 bridges are built for them. They are Tamil Nadu Area Development Board, all through Nirmiti Kendra. District Nirmiti Kendra is under district collector.
Right.
So I give the design, they supply the material, we work. Like that, 20 bridges. Now the government is changing. I don't know. Now there are no more orders in in hand here in Karnataka.
As soon as the government changes.
It depends. Again, they have to realize the importance and need for, and people have to go and discuss them.
Right.
There are so many proposals pending. Still about 20 proposals are pending now in Karnataka.
Wow.
Anyway, now we are going to Orissa, so no problem.
Excellent. Yeah, I know. But I'm surprised because the government changes and then everything stops. It's all very... Sir, can your projects not be treated as NREGA projects, sir, so that you get funds from and resources from the government? Is these projects not treated as NREGA projects, sir? The National Rural Employment Guarantee? Yes.
I think it may be possible, but it's not go for. So I was very busy for the past 3 years now, very busy with the... and I still one is pending.
Mm-hmm.
One bridge is half done. It was one side is of the river is Karnataka, other side is Maharashtra. So the Maharashtra range, the forest, range forest officer came and asked to stop the work. They have built pylons on both ends. One side anchor block is over. One side anchorage is to be built, and all the fabrication, everything is ready. It is pending. See, this is a system here. So we cannot waste time there. We wound up from there and came here. And one, sir, heavy floods are there. So you know, a small bridge. It is over. Hereafter, we can try, but... there is work going on all by one, so no problem. And I am getting aged now, so it is difficult also.
I know.
Because of the health.
Sir, I know you've done few of these bridges for service, few of these bridges collaborating with NGOs, few of these contracts with government. You know, lot of stress, lot of beating around the bush, running around places, meeting people, unable to meet expectations, you know, crazy people coming and then giving weird ideas. You would have seen a whole lot of various different phases in your construction of 120 bridges, right? How does your family how does your family react, sir? You just mentioned, right, you thought of giving up, and then again you listened to the Ramayana bhajans, and then you thought, okay, let me get back to the basics and then start up. So how does your family react, sir? What do they say about this?
Yeah, they have understood my vision, the spirit in me, and they fully cooperate. Now, my eldest son is M.Tech in the marine structures. He was working for an Australian company. Though he has left the job and has come here, he is looking at the workshop. In case we have still more works, he'll continue it. My son. And for our living, we have workshop with the general fabrication workshop with them.
Okay.
If we don't go searching for bridges, when it comes, we'll work.
Okay. Excellent.
And my wife, he fully cooperated. All of them know that there is a meaning in life, living life, you know.
Yes.
But I must appreciate the cooperation of my team people, my fellow men.
Mm-hmm.
So now they are also experienced. I go there, do marking, and give all the drawings and the specification. I keep on working. I'll frequently in the important, some crucial, then that time I go there. Three bridges we used to construct at a time. We had two, three teams. Huh? Now work is stopped. Now they are working in the workshop. Other fabrication work we are doing.
Oh, great. Sir, generally, what are those components that you use in building the bridges, sir? Is that a lot of them are wood or what are all the various...
No. See, this towers generally RCC. In some remote places where this material cannot be taken, all handled, then we go for built-up steel towers.
Mm-hmm.
And anchorages will be RCC only. Then this other things, the rope is still readily available, whatever size we order, we get it. And other things, suspenders, MS rods, I mean galvanized rods, we would know. Then steel channels, angles, and deck forging, we do this precast ferro cement slabs, you know, ferro cement.
Mm-hmm.
Ferro cement means actually it is steel and cement only, but the thin planks, 25 mm thick. Just like wooden plank, we make concrete slabs.
Right.
With the MS flat frame, it has the load. It is actually safer than wood, because wood gets deteriorated within 8 to 10 years, even if you give treatment. This doesn't fail at all. But if at all people misuse it, some cracks there, it is visible, and accident will not happen. About 20 years ago, this NIT, Srutkal Indian College people had built one bridge near Udupi.
Mm-hmm.
And they had put wooden planks.
Mm-hmm.
One day, the wooden plank was deteriorated. The president of the committee, he just fell down somewhere and he was dead.
Oh.
He was dead. So, these wooden planks, even though economical and less weight is less, they don't last long. Our this new ferro cement slab, it is an invention of a friend of mine from Puttur, one Mr. Anand Kumar.
Mm-hmm.
He suggested me, I asked him whether we can do something for mm-hmm. deck storing, economical with a lesser weight and all.
Mm-hmm.
He gave this, first he was supplying for our bridges.
Mm-hmm.
Then now he told me, you can do it yourself. Now we manufacture the ferro cement slab. It works out to be economical and has got little weight. The bridge has got more stability also. Otherwise, this hanging, rope structure, no?
Mm.
When the weight of the bridge is less, when a crowd goes at this end, other end gets lifted. Now, after putting the ferro cement slab, it's much more stable.
Mm.
And after providing stiffeners, it's still stable. No.
Excellent, yeah. Mm-hmm. Amazing. Sir, generally, once you conclude these projects, you finish the bridge, you mentioned few of these villagers and others were in tears, you know, you have so many of emotional moments that you've seen. Do you get some feedback on people saying that, sir, after you constructed the bridge, it's bringing our lives closer, we are seeing schools, hospitals, improving business. Can you share some examples of one state, one place where you constructed a bridge and what kind of feedback you received?
Yeah, there is every place. If I go to that place, no, they recognize me and they're joining their hands. They say namaskar. They say, And in one place, after 14 years, I went there to see somebody.
Mm-hmm.
While constructing the bridge, one boy was talking to me. He was going to the nearby school. And after 14 years, now he was 14 years. He was grown up. He just wished me, sir, could he recognize me? No. When he was talking to me, I was going to the school. And he was talking to me always. Oh, that was his name, he said. Then his father was coming there. I told him, how is your father? He is not feeling well, he said. Then I went. When I came back, he was waiting on the side of footpath. Sir, please come to my house.
Mm-hmm.
I said, no, what is, I'm in a hurry. No, his father told me that he had to come once. So I went there.
Mm.
He was sitting outside with a stick on one side. And I couldn't recognize because his face was a little twisted and hair was fallen.
Mm.
And then after going close to him, I could recognize this, one Mr. Prabhu. And he told, I went to sat next to him because I knew him. No?
Mm.
Then he could not lift the right hand. After the left hand, he lifted and held my hand and because of your bridge, I am survivor.
Oh, my God.
What happened? I said. And then his wife told me, night at 12 o'clock, he had this one, some stroke, something like that.
Mm.
Immediately, he was taken in the kumbhal with a stick, and they telephoned for a jeep to come near the bridge. He was carried to the bridge and taken to the hospital. The doctor told him that if half an hour late, he is not a survivor. So he told, his wife told me the story. Like that, these people, sometimes in different places they call me, sir, how are you? any places. Very often they remember me. One near Singiri, there is a place called Nemmar.
Mm-hmm.
When the bridge was getting constructed, it was rainy season. The one man, his son was sick. He had to carry him on back 4 kilometers and get an auto and they had taken to the hospital. So when the bridge is constructed, all the villagers, they gathered, and he was weeping with the gratitude. Even now, every month, one call I will have. Sir, I am on your bridge. And you are God to us. I am keeping your photograph in the this one prayer room. You are saying that. Well, I have gratitude, a lot of gratitude. I feel that my life is working.
Excellent, sir. Excellent. Sir Girishji, it's a great pleasure, great honor, and immense delight to talk to you today. And once again, sir.
Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, what he says, and I say, book Indomitable Spirit. This is for Towers Developed India, he speaks. To India, to get developed, the villages must develop.
Right.
There should be connectivity between among village clusters and rural urban.
Right.
Three types of connectivity. One is physical connectivity, second is electronic connectivity, third is knowledge connectivity. So this electronic connectivity and knowledge connectivity, we cannot do anything, but it is going on. The electronic one is very good now in India.
Right.
This physical connectivity is not done. We are rendering a small squirrel service to do this. And in that way also, I am proud that we are doing something for the development of the country. Feeling.
Very true, sir. Very true. Sir, if somebody is very interested to reach out to you, and then maybe there might be some people who wish to donate, or some people might to collaborate, some people will come up ideas on constructing a bridge in their own places, or some students might be interested to do an internship. You know, these days civil engineering is treated as a very as a totally different domain where people are not interested. So how do they reach out to you, and what is the best way to get connected to you, sir?
People are coming, but a small number. As I told you, from Roorkee, IIT Roorkee, three people totally got trained. And this NITK. But very less. Nowadays, the student, instructors, mentality, they want to make more money in short time.
Right.
But this is not remunerative, not much of remuneration. But a lot of trouble is there, a lot of challenges we have to face. Manpower, and the infrastructure, everything has to be developed. So now one man from Orissa, I told you, Mr. Narayan, he's having a workshop.
Right.
He has made up this band. He'll do it. And he's learning. He's not an engineer, but I told him, I'll give you the results. Now 2-3 pages will come and assist you. Later he said, maybe he was very happy. I think he'll come forward.
Excellent, excellent.
Not the engineer students, I don't know why they are not coming forward, I don't know. They are studying and going.
Yeah.
The man, the boys, two of them who came from Roorkee Engineering College, you know, one of them is writing for IAS, and another is writing for IES. They have the spirit. When last year I had two months I had been to IIT Roorkee to give a lecture on this rural connectivity and sustainable business. Then they told me, sir, when I get appointed in that place, I will see that all the villages are connected, the group villages. He has the spirit, but he does not take the risk at all. Little risk is there in this work, risk is there, no?
Right.
Training people and working like a circus, no? It is going on the top of the tower, over the ropes to fix the suspenders. It is something amazing, something thrilling also.
Right.
How people are doing it. Actually, the credit of my success goes to my fellow men. Because of them only I could achieve this much. My team is there, no?
Right.
Everything is for them only. I have the ideas, but I cannot work, no?
Very true. Right. And Girishji, I really, really appreciate your time today. Thank you very much for making to our show. I'm sure there's a lot of interest. We posted that Girishji will be on NRI Samay, and there's a lot of interest. People are saying, incredible things about you. They're happy that you'll be on air on this Saturday. This Saturday, 9:30 p.m. India time, it'll be aired on nrsmi.com.
Okay.
So once again, thank you very much, sir. Appreciate your help.
Welcome. Okay.
So, friends, that was Girish Bharadwaj ji, a man with a mission, and also, as I mentioned, he's famously and fondly called the Bridgeman, building bridges that link places, people, and hearts. And incredible work all throughout, starting from 1988 time frame, more than 20 years from now. Constructed more than 120 bridges, dealt with multiple projects, dealt with multiple teams and villages, and also dealt with multiple initiatives. Constructed incredible bridges that help bridge the communities in our country. And as you all know, that once you construct a bridge, it's like bringing schools, hospitals closer and improving the business and also rural economies. So, friends, I think you had a wonderful time listening to this show. And we hope you come back every week, Saturday and Sunday, same time, 9:30 p.m. India time, 9 a.m. Pacific USA time, 12 p.m. Eastern time, and 11 a.m. Central Time. Thank you very much. And also, you can listen to all our podcasts on youtube.com/NRI Samay. You can like us on Facebook, facebook.com/NRI Samay. And also, we do update on Twitter, twitter.com/NRI Samay. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful, wonderful weekend. Bye.